Okay, so let's go to cross-compiling temporary tools. So these, as it says here, are basic utilities which are going to be built using the tools we've just built, the cross-compiling tools that we've just built. Although these, as it says, as installed to final location, cannot be used yet, because the basic tools still rely on the host, but they're used when linking, so they're still quite important. And lastly, it does say that the whole chapter must be done as user LFS. So we just stay as we are. So begin with M4. Extract it. Change into the directory. Run the commands in. And prepare it for configuration. And build it with make. And finally we install it. That's it. Tidy it up and move on to ncurses. So extract the package once more, change into the directory and start running the commands. So there's only actually two real commands here. This is one command on its own and this pushd command. Although it's separate, it kind of embeds several commands within it, so I'll just run them individually. It does go with the popd, it pushes the directory and into like a saving area, so it can run these commands, run popd to return to where we were originally. So as it says there, this little bit is to build a program called tick on the build host. So that bit's configured okay. That looks like an error, it's not. It just looks the way it's happened, what is displayed on the screen. Okay, let's build that. So we'll run this popd to return to where we were. and now we can actually build the package proper. So that's configured, and now we can build it. And that's completed successfully, so we can install it. Seems to be done, so we can now run in just the last few commands to finish off. That's it. Go back to the sources, rm-rf, end curses, and we can move on to bash next. So once again, same process, extract, whoops, right, yeah, as before, that's not completing, so just check it, yeah, it's another patch file, so just extract it and change into it and run the configure. And build it with make. So it's all done. We can install that now. And once again, there's a few commands just to finish it off. So tidy up and move on. Okay, again, yep, it's got a patch. Run the configure. Okay, that's configured. Run the make to build it. Okay, that's done. Let's now install it. And then just run these commands in. Again, I'm going to do them one at a time just to make sure that they actually work without any errors. Okay, that's done. So tidy up and move on to diff utils. So this is quite a simple installation, this one. So that's configured. We'll build it with make. And install it. That's complete. And we'll do next file, next package, which is file. So this looks almost identical, if not identical, to the previous package. As far as installing is concerned. Build and make. And install it. And that's it. So tidy up. And move on. So once again, configure, that's successfully configured. We can build it with make now. Okay, it's done, and we can install it. And just a couple more commands to complete the installation. And that's complete. tidy up and move on to Gork. So first of all, we've got a set command, and then we can run the configure command. Okay, let's build it. And now it's time to install it. And it's done. So move on to grep. And I'm going to configure in first. Let's build now. And install. And that's grep complete. Move on to gzip. So once again, configure. Run make to build it. And install it. And one more command to finish up. And we can tidy up now. And move on to make. Configure again. Specialized configure for a lot of these packages. build it with make. And install. It's all finished, so tidy up. And move on to patch. So configure again. On make to build it. And install it. Finish off by tidying up. And move on to the next package, sed. Once again, configure. To make command to build a package. And install it. All done. So now move on to tar. And again, we do configure, make, install process, but as you can see, a lot of these configure commands are slightly different depending on the package. Okay, so now we can run make to build the package. and install it. It's done. And we move on to XZ. So configure. Build a package. And install. And when that's done, we've just got a few commands to complete the installation. Again, I'm running each of these commands in one at a time, just checking the output, looking for any signs of errors. Looks okay. All done. So now we move on to pass 2 of bin utils. So again, we unstract it, fresh extraction to make sure that there's no remnants of any previous builds that might affect the new build, because the new build's going to be in a different state or produce different outputs. We don't want anything we've previously done to affect what we're doing this time around. So run the configure again. Good with make, see how long it takes this time. It was about 3 minutes before. Okay, that's done, so it did take a little bit longer. I'm not quite sure what the reason for that is. Maybe we're asking it to compile more as we build up the system, but let's install that. And go back to the sources and remove the source directory. Bin utils. And we move on to GCC. Past 2. So we're going to the directory. I'm going to copy all these commands in at once because they all worked fine previously, so there's no reason why they shouldn't work now. And just have a quick scan down here anyway. Yep, it looks fine. Again, this is optional for 32-bit. It won't work or won't do anything on 32-bit. 64-bit, if you're having to be building for 64-bit, then you will need to run that in. So we make a build directory again. Make a directory. And create a link, symlink. Then we've got this big configure command. What I'm going to do, if I can find it, is to look back for the arch command that I've used before, so I don't have to type it in and risk. Oh, let's do that again. Yep, that's it. Risk mistyping anything, so I'm just going to get rid of whatever command this was. Looks like the libstandard C++ library, and I'm just going to paste this in prior, this configure command prior to all this. That hasn't worked as I expected for some reason. Oh, maybe all the enters that were there. So let's start again. Looks like I've got that on the screen. Yeah, so I can paste that in there. Just scroll back and copy the bit that I need, which is that bit there. So I'll just double check this looks okay. Configure. There's a bit I've just copied. We've got the with arch, with tune, with FPU, and the with float. So that looks fine. So I'll run that in now. So that looks okay. So I'm going to time this again because it's quite a long one. It was about 25-30 minutes before. So again, I'd expect it to be a little bit longer because as we go through this, we're building more functionality into each package. So let's see how that goes. Okay, that has built successfully again, so we can install this. Took a little bit longer than the first time. Just create a link to CC, which, as it says there, leaves the administrator to decide what compiler is installed on the system. When, as long as everybody uses CC, then it doesn't matter what the backend compiler is. So that's GCC pass 2 done. Remove that. That's done, so move on to entering truth and building additional temporary tools.